लट्लकारः मध्यमपुरुषे. डियर चिल्ड्रन, यस्टर्डे वी लर्न्ड यूसेज ऑफ प्रेजेंट टेंस इन थर्ड पर्सन. लेट अस लुक एट द यूसेज ऑफ प्रेजेंट टेंस इन मध्यमपुरुषः, दैट मीन्स सेकंड पर्सन टुडे. एस यू नो, सेकंड पर्सन मीन्स द लिसनर with whom we are talking, that should be used in Madhyama Purusha. In Madhyama Purusha, Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam appears as a subject. Tvam means you, Yuvam, you both, Yuyam, you all. Tvam, you in Ekavachanam, Yuvam, you two in Dvivachanam, Yuyam, you all in Bahuvachanam appears as a subject. Apart from this, nothing else can be used as subject. So, in Madhyama Purusha, it is easy to understand this subject. Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam alone appears as a subject. So, there will be no confusion for the usage of subject in Madhyama Purusha. Look it into the example. Tvam kadasi. Tvam kadasi. Tvam kadasi means you are eating. Here, the subject appears as tvam and verb ends with si. Kadasi. Always in present tense, Madhyam Purusha or present tense second person, verb ends with si, like kadasi, patasi, likasi, kridasi, chalasi, like this. So same way you can frame many sentences like tvam patasi, tvam likasi, tvam chalasi, tvam vasasi, tvam kridasi, tvam dhavasi, like this. We learned some verb roots before. Learn the meaning of those verb roots and try to apply in the sentences in the same manner. Let us move into Dvivachanam. Here are two persons or two things comes under Dvivachanam. Dvivachanam form is Yuvam Khadataha. Tvam Khadasi, you eat. Yuvam Khadataha, you both are eating, or you both eat. Here subject is yuvam, you two, and khadataha verb ends with thaha. Please note that difference. In pratham purusha khadataha small tha appears, here khadataha dirgha appears. So yuvam khadataha. The same way you can make many sentences like yuvam patathaha, yuvam chalathaha, yuvam kridathaha, yuvam likhataha, yuvam namathaha, like this. Now let us move into Bahuvachanam. Yuyam khadatha, yuyam khadatha. In Bahuvachanam, you all, yuyam is you all are eating, kadathal. So subject is yuyam, you all in Madhyam Purusha, and verb forms ends with kadatha, kadatha. That difference you must note down. So in Madhyam Purusha, verb ends with kadasi, kadataha, kadatha. So same way in Bahuvachanam you can frame sentences like yuyam patatha, yuyam likatha, yuyam hasatha, yuyam chalatha, yuyam kridatha, yuyam namatha, like this. So like this you have to learn to use verb roots in Madhyama Purusha. Kadasi, kadathaha, kadatha. Patasi, patathaha, patatha. नमसि नमथः नमथ पचसि पचतः पचत एक्सेट्रा. लेट अस लुक एट इनटू सम मोर एग्जांपल्स. हियर लुक एट द पिक्चर. व्हाट इज ही डूइंग? ही इज कुकिंग. कुक. यू कैन सी द कुक इन द पिक्चर. ही इज कुकिंग. व्हाट डू यू से फॉर कुकिंग इन संस्कृत? पचसि. पच टू कुक. व्हेन यू से दैट यू आर कुकिंग, त्वं पचसि. यू आर कुकिंग. व्हेन टू कुक्स आर कुकिंग हियर, युवां पचतः. यू बोथ आर कुकिंग. इफ मेनी आर कुकिंग, यूयं पचथ. यू ऑल आर कुकिंग. त्वं पचसि, युवां पचतः, यूयं पचत. प्लीज लुक एट इनटू द डिफरेंस ऑफ सिंगुलर, एकवचनम, ड्यूअल, द्विवचनम एंड प्लूरल, बहुवचनम. हाउ वर्ब फॉर्म चेंजेस अकॉर्डिंग टू द वचनम. पचसि, पचतः, पचत. दीज डिफरेंसेस इफ यू नोट डाउन देन ईजिली यू कैन फ्रेम सेंटेंसेस. Now let us move into another example. Here, what can you see in the picture? You can see a boy. What is he doing? He is bowing his hands. He is saluting. So, what do you say for saluting in Sanskrit? Nam. Nam to salute. So, boy is saluting here. Well, if you are talking to that boy, how can you say Tvam Namasi? Tvam Namasi. If there are two boys, Yuvam Namataha. You both are saluting. If there are many, Yuvam Namatha. You all are saluting. Like this, you need to understand to apply verb roots in Madhyam Purusha. So children, today we learnt usage of verb roots in Madhyam Purusha. Let us learn the usage of verbs in Uttam Purusha, first person, tomorrow.